today our topic is lipoma. Lipoma, which is benign neoplasm of, the name suggests lipoma means lipid, means fat cells, means benign neoplasm of fat cells. It is very common and universal benign tumor, 2.1 per 100 people. As it is universal means it can be everywhere in the body, but it not occur in brain. Not occur in brain because lipoma means lipid, lipid means fat cells, brain is devoid of the fat cells, so that's why it's not occur in brain. Benign neoplasm, okay, the fat cells which are in the lipoma is unavailable for the generation of ATP, means they are not generating ATP or they are not any concern about any metabolism of our body. So lipoma is classified according to three ways. The first is localized or diffuse. The second thing is superficial or deep. The third one is in according to the number, single or it can be multiple. In localized lipoma, it is encapsulated. And in diffuse, that is non-capsulated. Encapsulated localized lipoma, which is yellowish or orange in color, or the diffuse, which is more common on palm, sole, head and neck. And the diffuse lipoma, as it is diffuse, the difficult to surgery, and due to that incomplete surgery, the recurrence of that diffuse lipoma is very high. The other classification is superficial or deep. Superficial, it is mainly in subcutaneous plane, and the deep mainly in the intramuscular plane. The superficial is common in the back and neck. The deep is mainly lower limb, trunk, and which is associated more commonly with men. Third classification is single or multiple. Third classification is it can be single or it can be multiple. Single is very common. Multiple is more common in males and associated with many syndromes like Mann syndrome, Boniana syndrome, Proteus, etc. The other thing is multiple lipomatosis. The multiple lipomatosis, which is more common, the type of multiple lipomatosis, adiposa dolorosa, which is more common in females. In this lipoma, there are multiple lipoma situated in the body. Okay, there are some terminology. If the lipoma contained brown fat, it calls habonoma, which is serpentine vascular, which has some serpentine vascular elements. If lipoma is fibrous, it's called fibrolipoma, which is non-septal. Okay, the lipoma with telangiectasia, like the lipoma with telangiectasia, which is telangiectasia means the dark red blotches on the skin due to dilatation of the capillaries, which is known as the neolipoma. The lipoma which is in the nerve tissue, neurolipoma, and which is painful. Generally, lipoma are painless, but due to association with the nerve tissue, it is very painful. Other is angiolipoma, means concerned about the vascular element lipoma. Other one is lipoblastoma, which is benign tumor of immature fat in infant boys, which is congenital main lipoblastoma. Then other one is lipoma arborescens, which is diffuse venous nodule proliferation of synovium, which is associated with joint, synovium joint, diffuse venous nodule proliferation. The lipoma generally not lipoma has no secondaries, means malignant transformation not exist. But if liposarcoma is there, which it is not any malignant transformation, but it is arise from the primitive mesenchymal cells. Now we discuss anatomical size of the lipoma, which is subcutaneous, intramuscular, and if it's intermuscular, then abdomen. Subserosal in GIT tract, intraglandular in the breast, pancreas and kidney. The clinical feature, which is localized swelling, non-tender, non-transilluminant slip sign, means mobile with ages. There is one photograph at the end of the video which is showing the slip sign. And if pain, mainly this is painless, but if pain is occurred due to neural element, means neurolipoma, and it is non-tender, but if it is tender, then it is angiolipoma. Now we come to the differential diagnosis. If it is neurofibroma, firstly it is with pain, and the lump moves horizontally but not longitudinally along the line of the nerve. Neurofibroma is firmer. Second one is cystic swelling. Cystic swelling contains fluid, so we can differentiate it. The third one is liposarcoma, which is malignant. Generally, the lipoma is benign. The liposarcoma is common in retroperitoneum. Liposarcoma has rapid growth. Generally, the lipoma is benign condition, so it is occurs after 6 to 7 years of the latent period. After that, small growth. Then the liposarcoma has rapid growth. Liposarcoma can be blood spread to lungs and malignant. Okay.
Now we further move to the investigation part. First, ultrasonography, CT scan can be done, MRI can be done, but only needed. If only needed, it can be. But first go to the X-ray or US, means ultrasonography. We can use FNSE. We can use incisional biopsy. FNSE is generally cytology for cytology concern. This is the biopsy purpose. Okay. The complications of the lipoma. It can get maximatous changes, which is in retroperitoneal fibroma. In retroperitoneal fibroma, maximatous changes can occur. Then saponification, then calcification can occur. If it is submucous, then it get constipation and obstruct the intestine. The treatment is mainly excision, and if there is a small lipoma, under the local anesthesia, and if it is the large lipoma, under the general anesthesia. This completes our lipoma theory aspects. And now onwards, there are many photos